What's up, everybody? I'm Alex Campbell. We're here at the Monster Energy Star Racing Yamaha truck. And today we're going over Dylan Frandis' bike, which I'm in charge of week in and week out. Starting at the front of the bike, we have neck and handlebars. Dylan runs a pretty high bend bar. It's the R00002. Dylan likes his handlebars to turn pretty easy. And that way, if you were to flick it against the stop, it just barely bounces. And it just helps him with stability a little bit. Production stem, actually, for a flex carrier stick. In the neck and clamps. With it being a production stem, we use production top clamp nut and the spanner nut. We trim them just a little bit. He likes them a little bit narrower than where they come. Runs his levers kind of neutral to a high position. With the handlebars being pretty high already, it kind of makes the front brake line a little bit tight, which we're just running a stock brake line. And we just run that up a little bit and the clevis down on the clamp on the fork guard to allow for enough flex in the front brake hose. We run a stock front brake lever. The adjuster bolt is trimmed a little bit just so he can run the front brake lever a little farther in, and likes it a little closer to his hand. Runs a arc perch rigid 26 lever. The front brake master cylinder is stock, what comes on the bike. The throttle housing is production parts. The throttle cables are production as well. The throttle tube, these are the ODI lock-on grips and the V2. The throttle tube comes on the grip. So every week or whenever you replace the grip as needed, you get a new throttle tube as well, which I like a lot. Dylan adds, we cut another piece of grip and glue it to the inside of the throttle grip. That way it doesn't flex as much and his thumb can't touch the throttle housing and give him kind of a blister. He also runs ODI grip donuts. So we have all the brake banjo bolts are wire tied. That way if something knocks the line or anything, it can't come loose. And actually when I torque my banjo bolt, I keep the hose as high up as you can. That way it's fixed against the high side so it can't turn loose at all. Neck and triple clamps and bar mounts, and Dylan prefers their rigid bar mount. With these triple clamps, he runs the bar mount in the back hole, but the bar mounts are directional and he runs them forward. Yep, he runs the forks pretty high up in the clamp, and he always has. He doesn't like to adjust it very much. And they're literally as high up to the handlebar as they can go. Since we're talking about forks, he runs KYB A-Kit forks. They're the PSF1 air fork. Going down, he runs a Dunlop spec front tire, Kite hub, Excel rim with Kite heavy duty front spokes and nipples. Dylan is on the newest spec tire that Dunlop came out with for the front last season, I believe. A lot of guys are still on the old tire, and Dylan's been on this new tire, I think, since it came out, and he rarely changes. He loves it. He won't change it at all, really. And then we're on a titanium front axle that makes it a little more rigid, but Dylan doesn't complain about that at all. He prefers it. Stock fork lugs. Front brake rotor is from braking, and that is covered up by a light speed carbon disc. Stock front brake caliper and stock hanger. Stock brake pads, just how you get them off the shelf. So we run our production radiators, both left side and right side. Black radiator louvers, and then they're covered in twin air screens just to keep some of the sand out and the big debris. That way your little radiator cooling fins don't get bent, and those actually help save the radiators a lot. Cycroplastics throughout the whole bike, shrouds, front number plate, front fender, fork guards, the hood above the air filter, side panels, rear fender. Dylan likes his handlebars really clean. He runs his clutch perch a little bit further out. The clutch lever comes to the end of the handlebar. That way we have the kill switch towards the inside of the handlebar compared to the clutch perch. We just have a stock kill switch and stock start button. We don't do the map button on the handlebar. We just do it with the computer between the sessions if need be. Our engines are done in-house by Brad and Jeremy, both. Dylan runs a pretty neutral engine package compared like with all the other guys do as well. For certain tracks and things like that, we'll change up a few things or maybe a few things with clutch and things like that, but pretty easy going on things like that. And he's always been really happy with the engine package, and the Vortex ignition is all the mapping stuff. The ignition cover is a GYTR part. The case saver is just the stock piece without the plastic on it. Recluse clutch, the torque drive. Dylan does like to run a little bit stiffer clutch springs, so it's pretty simple change but that's one thing we do use to tailor to him on certain tracks, sometimes a little bit more, a little less pressure here or there. And he can be very hard on the clutch. We'll adjust things to best suit him out on the track as well if we need to. So Dylan runs a production shift lever in the standard position. Raptor titanium foot pegs and titanium mounts, all standard position. Titanium foot peg pins as well. So we have titanium engine mounts in the front and the head hangers, which Dylan really likes. He's liked them since day one on this chassis. And we have all titanium hardware for the engine mounting. He doesn't complain about anything like that rigidity. We have a titanium pivot as well through the back of the engine and the swing arm. The Ty swing arm pivot is plugged with Delrin. It's just pressed in there to keep any mud and debris out of there as need be. Right side of the frame, it actually fills the frame out that way when you're washing and you don't get any mud in there or can get behind the brake pedal. We do a KYB A-kit shock. Compression assembly has high speed comp, low speed comp, the rebound, and we also have the rebound on the bottom as well. And that way when he pulls into the pit, we can make a quick adjustment if we need to and then get him back out there. The shock is just coated with DLC, the shaft is, and then the spring is just a standard spring with the blue powder coat on it. The chain slider and the lower chain roller and upper chain roller are all production pieces. Dylan runs a standard height subframe. I mean, we've tested with other ones before, but he prefers the standard height. Dylan runs a decor seat cover. He runs the decor seat cover without any ribs in it, and he runs a bump. He likes the bump in order to hold them in place on the start a lot. And the bump, I just tape a piece of bar pad down is all I do. He's the only rider on the team that doesn't run any ribs on his seat cover. The exhaust coming out of the engine, we have a full FMF factory system from the header to the mid pipe and the muffler. So the muffler has a lot to do with sound, and we do different specs if we need to. The header and mid pipe are both the best we can produce for Supercross, and as far as like outdoors, we'll tailor if we need to, but Supercross, we've been running the same one all season. For the rear chain block, we use a Lightspeed carbon piece, and inside of the carbon piece is a production guide. Chain is an EK chain with Vortex rear sprocket. The sprocket is held on by titanium bolts, a Kite rear hub in the rear, Dunlop spec rear tire, and an Excel rim. The rear axle is titanium, and it's mounted with Zeta blocks. Right now, we're running the axle kind of in the middle of the adjustment there. Keeps Dylan happy both in the whoops and in the turns. And we can adjust it, add a link to the chain if we need to get a little more stability through the whoops. But he likes his axle right there. He rarely changes that type of stuff either. The rear brake disc is a braking disc and is held on by six titanium bolts. The rear caliper is a production piece with production brake pads. We have a nice carbon rear caliper cover. And then going forward, we have a production brake line, and we have a works master cylinder without the window. So it's just kind of a safety thing. It's very rare that you're gonna have something hit your sight glass, but if something did and you were without a rear brake, it wouldn't be much of a race, so. We do run a different length for Supercross. Gives Dylan's his best feel for Supercross, that is, and it's a worst part, the knuckle and the pull rod. GYTR brake clevis. So we have a production brake pedal, and then we weld on a piece that's threaded, and we put a bolt in there. That way, if the rear brake pedal gets hit up by a rut or another rider or anything like that, it jams it and it can't rip the internals out of the rear master cylinder. We have a brake snake on the brake pedal as well. So the cable on the rear brake pedal is there. That way, if the brake pedal gets caught in a rut or on a tough block or another rider, anything like that, the brake pedal will only bend out until that cable gets tight. That way it doesn't bend all the way around the foot peg and not have a rear brake for the whole race. So it's just kind of a precautionary thing. The Zeta engine plugs, they're aluminum engine plugs. They're just anodized blue. We move the water temp sensor up into the hose. So Trevor, Colt's mechanic here at Star, he builds these pieces and then we get them anodized. And it just moves the water temp sensor a little bit further up in the hose and not right on the spigot where it comes production. It just saves a little bit of vibration on the sensor, and it's more accurate that way for us, and we've had good luck with it that way. On the right side of the bike, we use Oetker clamps. That way you don't have to check them. They're as tight as they can be all the time. Those are just a part we get and clamp on there. The left side though is just a standard hose clamp. That way if you bend a radiator, you just take the right side off, and that way you can get to the left side that way. We have a Lightspeed glide plate, carbon glide plate under the engine. On the right side of the frame spar, we have a second start button. That way if something was to happen in the first turn, and the one up on the handlebar comes off, breaks, gets damaged, anything like that, the rider knows that down here he can just reach down and press the button. It's really hidden in there, that way nothing can hit it, and it's honestly pretty hard to spot right there behind the shroud, but it is there as precautionary and would come in handy if need be. We use a 1.8 radiator cap over what comes on it is a 1.1, and that just adds a little bit of pressure, that way you're not gonna push your coolant out. We use a Works Connection hole shot device. Dylan is kind of mediocre on that, maybe a little bit to the deep side, but for Supercross on the grate, you kind of have to be because you have so much traction all the time. We adjust the height if need be here and there, but we just have one button on there, so we either change the fork guard or just slide the ring up on the fork just a little bit if you're in a hurry and need to. We use Yamalube products in the engine and outside, both motor oil, chain lube, their plastic coatings. Literally anything that they make, we pretty much use and we love it. So we use a Vortex ignition and data accusation system, and we just do that for safety precaution stuff. It's not super visible and we don't do a lot of it, but it is handy to have stuff like that. If you think something could be going wrong, you just get on the laptop, look in there, and make sure everything's good. As far as graphics go, we use Decor Visuals on the graphics all the way through the bike and their seat cover. They do a good job of keeping us supplied, and it's pretty durable stuff. Yeah, we do use a thin material from Decor to keep the weight down a little bit, and we trim around the numbers on the side panels just to keep the weight down, and then it doesn't peel up in their boots because Dylan stands up a lot, so he's pretty hard on the side of the bike. We use a Twin air filter system. Those guys keep us dialed in all the time. We're never sucking any dirt through our air filters or anything like that. His attention to feeling something different, he can really tell when something's off on his handlebars or his seat or anything like that. He's pretty picky. He's a good rider, and once I get to this level, they all kind of are picky in some their own certain way. Going back to all the titanium fasteners on the bike, axles, plastic bolts, throughout the whole bike is MetTech supplying us with that stuff. It's great titanium, it's very durable. We use it, new stuff on the race bike all the time, but at the end of the year, the race bike becomes a test bike and then a practice bike, and we just keep reusing the titanium with no issues at all from the guys at MetTech. We do our engines in-house, and Jeremy Coker rebuilds them week in and week out. Each rider, and Dylan in this case, has engines for Supercross and outdoors, and they're just labeled with DF Race for Dylan Ferrandis race engine, and then we do it that way just to keep track of how much time is on them, and that way they keep them fresh for each rider. Inside the engine, we have Wasner's pistons. They do a lot of research and development with us, and they make a great product for us. And then we have an acetylene valve train, really durable. We normally don't have any issues in that aspect at all. They're always within adjustment, and we inspect those very often. For race gas, we use VP Racing Pro 6 fuel for Supercross. We use that both practice and race.